Hello, my name is Tom, community manager at Urban Games. Today I have the great pleasure to show you, for the very first time, gameplay of Transport Fever 2. Transport Fever 2 is a tycoon game where the player connects towns and industries to let the world grow and to earn money. Trains, ships, planes and different types of street vehicles are available to build up a transport company. The game starts in 1850 and the player experiences the change of time until today. All content, including stations, towns or people, is changing its look over time. In this video, I will show you a fictional map around 1970. We are on an island and I have already built up some things, so I can give you a good introduction into the game. The map was built with the tropical climate zone and we use here the Asian vehicle set. Transport Fever 2 also contains a temperate and dry climate zone, as well as a complete European and American vehicle set, so our beautiful island is a very specific example. The main goal of the game is to build up a profitable transport company. You earn money by transporting people and cargo. Towns play a central role in the game. The more they grow, the more money you can make. So let's have a look at how towns work. If we, for example, zoom into Haikou, we see the inhabitants, which are all individually simulated. Let's have a closer look and click on somebody. Here's Elizabeth, currently going shopping by foot. Here's Wolfgang, currently driving home by car. People always move from their home to work, then they go home again, then they go shopping, and so on. It's the task of the player to find out where they move and build transport infrastructure there, so that Elizabeth and Wolfgang no longer need to walk or use their cars. There is a layer to visualize these three land uses. People live in the green buildings, go to shopping in the blue commercial buildings, and go to work in the yellow industrial buildings. Now let's look at the bigger picture and see what towns need to grow. For that, I open the town window, which explains in detail how town grow works. Here we see all requirements, the current level of fulfillment, and the impact on town growth. We will fulfill some of them in this video. The first requirement is the reachability of workplaces and shopping facilities via public transport. According to the town window, on average, the inhabitants of this town can already reach about 350 destinations, thanks to the shipping line going to another island and the train line connecting one of the neighboring towns. However, not all people can reach the harbor train stations, as stations have a limited catchment area, shown here with the white highlight. People outside of this area are not able to walk to the station and can't use the connections offered there. Therefore, to further increase the town's reachability number, we need to extend the reach of the station. We should introduce a bus line, so that people can drive to the station by bus. Starting close to the station, I will connect all three land use districts to the station, so that people from Haikou can reach the train station and harbor by bus, and also people from the neighboring towns can use the train and ship to come to Hakoi for work and shopping. We will end the line at the harbor with a terminal station to leave room for additional lines or a later expansion with a cargo platform. Having built the stations, it's just a couple of clicks to add a new line connecting them. To make it easier to find it later, I type in a name and set a color. Now we need a depot, where we can buy buses and assign them to the line. The buses will spread out automatically after a short time. As we can see, the number has already increased significantly, as the inhabitants of Haikou have now more places to go for work and shopping. This will help grow the city. We can still increase the value by expanding the public transport even further. As Hanoi already has a bus service near the train station, another good option is to expand the train line. For that, I reconfigure the terminus station in Hanoi to allow the expansion of the line to Kaohsiung. Changing a station configuration can be easily achieved by just removing the main building and replacing it at the proper spot. This train station was built some time ago, and the historical parts of the station, like the platform and roofs, will be kept intact as long as we don't remove them. In Kaohsiung, we can place a train station right next to the existing tram terminal. Stations placed next to each other allow passengers and cargo to switch between transport modes without the need of a road between them. Of course, stations can be placed in different configurations from the get-go. Now we have to connect the two stations. For that, I will activate the layer for overlaying height lines. This helps to find the path with the lowest inclination and least required earthwork, which is important to allow trains to go faster as they don't have to climb hills. It also saves money by constructing. I will soon operate more than one train on this route, so I will build a double track configuration, which needs some switches before the train stations. I'm also adding signals to allow trains to drive relatively close behind each other and they don't have to wait for a free track in a station. Now let's edit the line and add Kaohsiung as a new stop. I also add Hanoi a second time so that the train will stop there on its way back. The utilization of the line will soon increase, so we also have to raise its capacity. This can be done by editing the existing trains. For example, we can replace the wagons with ones that have more seats, or we can add more wagons to the train. To reduce the time people have to wait for a train, we add additional trains to the line. The quickest way is to clone an existing train. Let's wait for the new trains to leave the depot and drive to their first stop on the line. To shorten waiting time, we can increase the speed of the simulation. The time it takes for one calendar day to pass can also be changed, and the time progression can even be stopped completely. Now Haikou is well covered with public transport, so let's have a look at the next requirement, private transport. While many people will switch to our services, some will always prefer the car. With close to 1900 reachable destinations, the value is already high, but it can still be improved. If we have a look at the destination layer, we can see where people are going by public and private transport. If we filter by Haikou, we can see that nobody currently is going to Manila. And to reach Kaohsiung, they also have to go through Hanoi, which there may cause traffic jams and emissions. Let's provide a shortcut for all the traffic by building a highway between Haikou and Kaohsiung. We could even build a more direct route with a tunnel, but that would be very expensive and I want to save money for later projects. Directly connecting the highway to the edge of the city may result in a bottleneck, so it is advised to come back later and see how the situation developed and if it needs further improvement. Next, we have a look at the demand for cargo. Each city demands two different cargo types. One has to be delivered to the commercial and one to the industrial district, as we can see here in the cargo layer. Haikou's commercial district demands food, which is one of the more simple chains, so let's start with that one. Luckily, there is a food factory not far away from the city. Currently, it is not producing anything because it lacks the required resources, in this case, grain. So let's find a nearby farm which can supply the food factory. We could use any transport mode to deliver the grain, but in that case, it makes sense to use trucks, as the farm and the food factory are relatively close to each other and we have already built a highway, so give it a second purpose and also use it for our trucks. To load and unload our trucks, we need truck stations, so let's build one next to the farm and the factory. Let's set up another line for our trucks. And let's build a depot to buy new trucks. Many trucks have specialized versions that can only carry certain cargo types, but have the advantage of more capacity in return. As we only deliver grain on this line, I will buy a couple of specialized trucks and assign them to the line. The farm is now putting its grain onto the truck stations where trucks can pick it up. This is also shown in the information window of the farm, where the shipping value is now maximized. As soon as the trucks drop off the grain at the food factory, the grain counts as transported. Thus, the transported value is also increasing. It to reach 100% unless some grain is not delivered due to overflowing stations. At the same time, we can see that the food factory starts producing food, but now also has nowhere to ship its goods, so wheel it to Haikou. The train station is located in the commercial district where the food has to be delivered, so this is a good opportunity to use the station to drop off the cargo. It is currently a passenger station, so we will expand it with a new track and platforms, which are suitable for cargo pickup and delivery. At the food factory, let's build a train station attached to the truck terminal, as the truck terminal can serve as a connection between the train station and the food factory. Let's again connect the two stations with tracks. For the moment, I will only use one train on this line, so we can keep the tracks simple and there is no need for switches or signals. Should there be the need for a second train later on, we can add a passing loop or expand the tracks to a double configuration. I already added a new line and built a new depot, so the only thing left to do is to buy a new train. In this case, we need to pick wagons which can carry food. Let's wait for the train to make a couple of deliveries and have a look at the info video of the food factory. Now that the factory can ship its goods, the shipping value is increasing, and later on the transport value will rise too, as soon as the food arrives in the city. This now also has a positive impact on growth, which will even increase further when more deliveries are made. When all three values of an industry, production, shipping and transport, are above a certain threshold, the industry will grow to the next level, allowing it to produce and ship more cargo. Here, the next step would be to connect another farm to supply more grain and eventually find a new city to deliver the food to. As I pointed out before, every city has a demand for two different cargo types. For the second example, let's find a more complex chain and go to Manila. Here, the industrial district demands machines. Machines require steel, which we can get from this island. Here, I have already set up truck lines to deliver coal and iron to the steel mill, and a shipping line to deliver the steel from the steel mill to the machines factory. Another truck line is delivering wood from two forests to a sawmill, where it is turned into planks, which is the second cargo required to produce the machines. And there's a truck line already supplying Manila with the machines, and thus the factory did already grow. There is still some shipping capacity left, so we need another customer. There is a passenger airline going from Manila to Jakarta, so let's use part of the existing infrastructure. For that, we need to add cargo terminals to both the airport in Manila and the airfield near Jakarta. Both airports have bus terminals next to them, so let's expand them too and add some cargo platforms. In Manila, I will use the existing truck line by adding a new stop to deliver machines also to the airport. Keep in mind that we should check if the current amount of trucks on the line is enough to both supply Manila and Jakarta with machines from the machines factory. The industrial district in Jakarta is the destination for our machines. To avoid bulldozing buildings, we can use this drop-off stop and place it on the sidewalk. The new lines also need vehicles, so let's buy some planes and trucks. Note that there are two categories of planes, small and large. On old airfields, like the one near Jakarta, only small planes can land. Modern airports can handle both small and large planes. Something similar is true for ships. Large ships need bigger landings to be able to dock at the harbor. While our inhabitants are now happy to have public and private transport services, as well as a good supply with cargo, there are also things that hinder city growth, so let's briefly touch on them as well. With growing cities and more people using our services, stations may begin to overcrowd. Here in Haikou, we can see that several stops of our bus line are already overcrowded, and so potential customers may not use this bus line as a consequence. A good measure is to add more or newer buses with more capacity, or add an alternative line which provides a shortcut between the most crowded stations. If a train or bus terminal is running out of space, we can also increase the length of the platforms. In Kaohsiung, we can see that there is heavy traffic on several roads. This is probably due to our addition of the highway from Hakau. To counter that, we can upgrade the road to a wider version. Houses will be moved if possible, so the cost stays manageable. Crowded junctions may also be upgraded with traffic lights, or a roundabout can be added to ease the flow of traffic. In Jakarta, we have an issue with the emissions of our recently added trucks. However, in that case, we can easily address it. When we added the truck line to deliver machines, the line was routed through a road next to the residential district. To avoid the residential district, we can build a bypass. This has two positive effects at once: the emissions are kept away from the inhabitants, and the route is even a bit shorter, increasing the amount of cargo our trucks can deliver. In other situations, reducing emissions might need more work, like rerouting entire train lines or reallocating noisy airports, replacing vehicles with more modern versions, or adjusting the maintenance level is another option to counter rising emissions. I hope you enjoyed this brief look into the gameplay of Transportiva 2. Of course, there is much more we didn't have time to cover in this video. This map was only one example of the challenges provided by the several game modes. If you want to enjoy an entertaining story with varied tasks, there's a campaign mode with 18 missions waiting for you. And the map editor and the random map generator allow for virtually limitless possibilities to create and share your own challenges. In addition, a sandbox mode is available if you prefer to build whatever you like without being concerned about the financial aspects of the game. If you want to learn more, visit our YouTube channel and have a look at the past development highlight videos, which cover the map editor and other interesting topics. Thank you all very much for your attention. We are looking forward to finally releasing the game. All the best and friendly greetings from the whole team at Urban Games. Bye bye.